morning, guys. Welcome to my channel. My name is Emily and I'm back with another vlog today. I worked last night and I woke up so sore and so tired. So I decided to go for a run because I discovered that if I ignore the soreness and the fatigue and then go for a run, even though it goes against all my instincts at that moment, it gives me this amazing natural high and my soreness and my fatigue disappear almost completely. But today I'm only doing a 5 kilometer run around the kennels and then back to my house. I have a very busy day ahead of me, so I'm just mentally preparing myself for that a little bit. But I'm very excited. So if you're interested in taking a look into my life, then please keep watching. I just got back from my workout. I took a shower and now I'm doing my makeup. My boobs are pressed up so high. I know, I'm sorry, but I'm wearing this corset. It goes up all the way until here. And it really presses my boobs up really high. So I have to find a solution for that. But I used to wear corsets like every day. I was obsessed with corsets. But then I got my belly button pierced. And it did not really go well together because every time I would wear it, my piercing got infected. So I made the decision to stop wearing my corsets completely until my piercing fully healed. And now whenever I wear my corset, I take my piercing out, and when I take it off, I just put my piercing back in, and that works fine. So I'm really gonna start wearing my corsets again. I'm so excited. I have many different colors. And I also have a new necklace. It says Emily and it's in honor of the channel and you guys. And I also have a new toe ring. Let me show you. It's a golden ring with a light blue stone in the middle. I'm sorry for the state that my toes are in, but I'm having a lot of blisters from my work shoes, so it's a bit nasty. Let's put on my lip gloss because that's always fun. And my perfume, my new one of Tom Ford, this one. Let's go. I am on my way to my band rehearsal. It's raining a bit. I'm quite disappointed, I must confess, because I was so excited for this band and the guys are so kind, so nice, and we're quite good together. And we have our first performance in the end of August, so next week already. However, one guy, the drummer, is going to go to college to the conservatoire in the other side of the country. So he's leaving the band. And I must admit that I already knew that beforehand, but I always get my hopes up. It's like one of my worst character traits. I always have too high expectations and I always think that no, it's gonna be fine, we're gonna build something really big and we're gonna perform everywhere and travel the world. But obviously he is leaving for college and the other guys are also going to do a full-time study, and obviously I just finished my school, so I just want to work full-time and I really want to take this seriously. So for me it's so disappointing because I was really excited for this band, but it's fine. I mean, I'm just gonna find another band. Now we have this 4-hour rehearsal and I really have to find my motivation. So yeah, I'm just gonna get some coffee.
Yes, thank you so much, have a good day.
Well, there were a lot of miscommunications, but we fixed all of them, so I think we're ready for Saturday. I have to leave for work in like 45 minutes, so I still have time for one quick practice session for my violin and my piano. Thank you.
to work right now. I also went to Hunkemöller and H&M to buy some stuff for tonight to wear. Look. I'm also listening to the audiobook of The Picture of Dorian Gray for the 100th time. I also read it multiple times. It's such a good book. It's about a beautiful boy who sells his soul to the devil for eternal youth. And it's by Oscar Wilde. He's a genius. He was gay at the time, which was so forbidden. And so a bonus of the book is that it has a lot of homoeroticism in it. And I love that. So I could really recommend this book because it has a lot of valuable lessons and a lot of underlying messages that are really interesting.
Schatje! Hey. Hoe is het?
Goed met jou?
Finished working.
Hell yeah!
I'm with my colleague. Her name is also Emily.
Yeah, Emily.
But she's the first Emily and I'm the second Emily. So every time that someone says Emily, I'm like, what? Oh, no, the other Emily.
Yeah, but you're the brightest one.
Hey, Emily, no. Let me ask you a question.
Yeah, I have to ask her.
I know.
No, she's Emily.
I know her name.
It was a long day. I'm gonna do a money count for you guys. Let's see how much I made tonight. It was not really a good night for me because I did not really feel myself because I was a little bit too tired. And then I performed not as well. And then you make less money. Then it's like a vicious cycle. So let's see how well I did. This is 5, 10, 350s. 320, 470, 485. I made 485 euros tonight, which is actually quite good still for the night that I had. So I'm very thankful and grateful for that. Forgive me for my low energy because I am so tired. Just make myself some tea. And I still want to answer questions that you guys ask me because I really love it when you guys ask me questions. So one of you guys asked me if I could point out the differences between the clubs in the US and the clubs in Holland. And I must say that I have never been to a strip club in the US, so I'm quite ignorant. But I have seen photos, videos, and people talking about it, so my opinion is going to be based solely on that. But I think that the difference that stands out by far the most is the fact that in Holland, prostitution is legalized, it's regulated. So there are two markets that act next to each other. It's like a blurred line. The point I'm trying to make is that strip clubs in Amsterdam or in Holland are not necessarily only strip clubs. Some clubs in Holland provide both services, so prostitution and dancing. And I believe that in the US, there's only strip clubs that only provide dancing. We really have to find the target market, like the market that only wants entertainment. Because we are entertainers, we're not prostitutes, even though I have a lot of respect for prostitutes. I really hold them in high regard. But personally, I really enjoy giving shows. So I really was looking for a club that only provided dancing. The second aspect in which Holland differs from the US with regards to strip clubs is that the clubs have a different layout. So what I've seen is that in the US you have these huge clubs with multiple stages and multiple girls dancing at the same time, and these VIP areas and these huge private rooms. However, in Amsterdam, my club is quite small. It's like typical Amsterdam, an old building, very vintage style aesthetics, and it actually reminds me of a movie that I watched. It's called Coyote Ugly. I will put it in the description box. And the bar, quite reminds me of the club that I work. It's like this huge bar with two poles on the side and everyone's standing around it, and it's really actually quite cool. But it's very different from the layout of the clubs in the US. Thirdly, the business model, I think, differs quite a lot. Because in the US, I believe that the girls have to tip the manager, the house mom. We don't have a house mom. The DJ, we don't have a DJ. We can put our own music. And if I'm not mistaken, the girls also have to split their earnings with other girls. Sometimes they share a VIP room. However, in our club, we only have to pay 20 euros each night to the manager. And after that, all the stage money is ours. However, the business model works as follows, is that the clients can buy the girls champagne, and then the girls make a percentage of that money. This is in order to align incentives with the dancers and the management, because our club makes the most money out of entrance money and the drinks. Finally, the last difference that really stood out to me, and it's also an answer to another question that I was asked by one of you guys, is our working schedule. So how does it work? Can you just show up and leave whenever you want? How many times do you go on the stage each night? I believe in the US, you can just show up and leave whenever you want, which is so interesting and crazy sounding to me. But in our club, you have to give your days that you prefer to work to the manager for the next 2 weeks. And then the manager makes a schedule. So Peter, you have seen him in my previous vlogs. He makes a schedule with all the days that you work. And when you are given those days, you have to show up. And on the night itself, you dance approximately once every hour. And during the time that you don't dance, you can sit at the bar and sell champagne or cocktails. So you also make money off of that. The final difference is that we do not have rooms. We don't have private rooms. We only have the main area. I think it's different from clubs in the US where there are private rooms, like champagne rooms. But in our club, you can only buy the girl champagne and sit at the bar in the main area. But now I'm going to go to bed because I'm exhausted. Thank you so much for watching. Really, thank you so much for your time. Please consider subscribing to my channel and also leave a like, a comment if you like this video.